Today, I will talk about natural language processing, NLP, and I will share the 20 examples to make sure we all understand what it really is. Hello everyone, I am Riccardo Osti, and on a daily basis help the most successful companies to increase their profitability by investing in the consumer experience. If you are a subscriber of this channel, the term NLP won't be new to you. However, if this is the first time you're hearing about natural language processing, also known as NLP, you want to know that it's basically using computers to derive meanings from human languages. Now, this might seem like a pretty innovative and cutting-edge technology, but the truth is that NLP is something that's been part of our lives for years. In fact, customers from across the globe interact with NLP on a daily basis without even realizing it. Want to learn more about NLP and its many uses? In this video, I share 20 natural language processing examples across a wide range of industries. So what is natural language processing? To expand on our earlier definition, NLP is a branch of artificial intelligence that helps computers understand, interpret, and manipulate human language. To learn more about NLP, you watch my other video. It's over here and in the description. Now that you've got a better understanding of NLP, let's deep dive into these 20 natural language processing examples that showcase how versatile NLP really is. Number 1. Social media monitoring. Top on our list of natural language processing examples is none other than social media monitoring. If you've ever used a social media monitoring tool such as Hootsuite or Buffer, these are basically built using NLP technologies. These tools help you monitor media channels for mentions of your brands, or you can create alerts when consumers are talking about you or your products. As many marketers and business owners will know, having a negative review going viral on social media can destroy a brand's reputation overnight. Bearing this in mind, it's important for companies to engage in social media monitoring and social media listening to make sure that they address any potential crisis immediately. Number 2, sentiment analysis. Next to our natural language processing examples is sentiment analysis, which is often used in social media monitoring analysis. While the latter refers to monitoring the social media landscape and listening to the conversations as a whole, the former deals specifically with identifying opinions and determining whether the author of the post holds a positive, negative or a neutral opinion towards a brand, the product, and so on. Again, NLP comes into the picture here. Basically, using NLP, sentiment analysis tools, pick emotionally charged words that are used to describe a brand or the customer's experience with that brand. For instance, if a post contains plenty of positive language, such as amazing, fantastic, wonderful, then the tool might conclude that the overall sentiment of this talk or this text is positive. With sentiment analysis, companies can gauge how receptive their customers are to a particular product or service, or even to a recent change they've implemented. For example, a change in the return policy of an e-commerce or in the support policy. Number 3, text analysis. Text analysis can be broken in different categories, including morphological, grammatical, syntactic, and semantic analysis. By analyzing text and extracting different types of key elements, such as topics, people, dates, locations, companies, and so on, companies can better organize their data, and from there they can identify useful patterns and insights. For instance, e-commerce or manufacturers can conduct text analysis of their product reviews in order to find out what customers like or dislike about their products, and also to know how their customers are using their products. To do this, these companies need NLP-powered tools like the one developed by my company, Wonderflow. Number 4, survey analytics. Apart from analyzing their product reviews, companies can also analyze the survey result in order to come up with really actionable insights. Again, NLP helps these companies to make sense of all their raw data and generate useful insights and takeaways. Of course, companies who are conducting small-scale surveys may still choose to manually analyze their data and come up with recommendations. That said, if you're surveying your entire database of tens of thousands of customers, then it is not feasible to sit down and sift through all the results yourself. Here, automating the process using an NLP equipped tool makes much more sense. In the end, why would you send a Net Promoter Score to all your customers if you cannot learn from it? If you are interested in this matter, watch this other video here, where I explain why you should analyze NPS data. You will also find all the links that I mentioned in the description. Number 5 is quite different. It's spam filters. Think spam isn't a huge problem? Think again. According to statistics, spam accounts for 45% of the emails sent, about 14.5 billion emails every single day. Now, looking at the statistics that I just mentioned, you may be wondering why you don't get more spam. Well, that's because we've got excellent spam filters that flag dodgy emails as spam and prevent them from reaching your primary inboxes. How do these spam filters work? Among other factors, such as deliverability, email domains, etc., these filters use NLP technology to analyze email subject lines and their body content. From here, it is fairly easy for them to ascertain what's spam and what's not. Emails that contain plenty of capitalized texts and words such as free, promotion, buy now, etc., usually have a high chance of being spam. I hope you enjoyed the first 5. If so, subscribe to my channel by hitting the subscribe button. And also click the bell close to it, because you will receive a new mail or message every time I publish a new video. When do I post new videos? Simple, every Monday and Thursday. So stay tuned.